Thank you. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله نشهد أنه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح لهذه الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما ثم أما بعد عباد الله فإن خير الحديث كلام الله عز وجل وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. معشر المسلمين، يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى في محكم التنزيل: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، ألف لام ميم، تلك آيات الكتاب الحكيم، هدى ورحمة للمحسنين. الله سبحانه وتعالى has said at the beginning of Surah Luqman, what can be translated as Alif Lam Mim, these are verses of the wise book, which is Al-Quran al-Kareem, a guide and a mercy for the muhsineen, the good doers. وفي سورة لقمان أيضا يقول سبحانه وتعالى: ومن يسلم وجهه إلى الله وهو محسن فقد استمسك بالعروة الوثقى وإلى الله عاقبة الأمور. And whoever submits his face to Allah and he is a fair doer and he is among al-muhsinin and he does ihsan, then he has upheld fast the most binding grip, and to Allah is the end of all command. ويقول سبحانه في سورة النساء: واعبدوا الله ولا تشركوا به شيئا وبالوالدين إحسانا. And worship Allah and do not associate anything with him, and do good to parents and do ihsan to your parents, your fathers and mothers. وفي سورة النحل آية واضحة عظيمة الشأن، يقول سبحانه: إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. Indeed, Allah orders justice and good conduct and order you to do al-ihsan and giving to relatives and forbids immorality and bad conduct and oppression. He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, admonishes you that perhaps you will be reminded. نسأل الله أن يجعلنا منه. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the theme of Al-Khutbah today is Al-Ihsan. Al-Ihsan, if you want to define Al-Ihsan related to Al-Islam and Al-Iman, is Husnul Ta'a. It's the best worship. It's to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfectly. And in that meaning, when Jibreel alayhi salam asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about al-ihsan, the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam replied, al-ihsanu an ta'bud Allah ka'annaka tarah fa in lam takun tarahu fa innahu yarak. In this perspective, al-ihsan is the best worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-ihsan is to worship Allah as if you are seeing him jalla jalalu. But indeed, you cannot see Allah in this life, but you believe, you have strong belief that he is seeing you. This is al-ihsan. But if you want to define al-ihsan in general, al-ihsan huwa fi'lu ma huwa hasan, to do something good. The action that you do or the deed that you did should be good. This is al-ihsan. And some scholars define it in different definition. They said al-ihsan naw'an, al-in'am 'ala al-ghayr wal-ihsan fi fi'l al-khayr. Listen to this. Al-ihsan al-in'am 'ala al-ghayr. That means to do good deed, to do something beneficial to others, not to yourself. This is al-ihsan. Al-ihsan when your khair, your goodness reaches others. In this case, this is ihsan. And the other condition or the other part of the definition which is very important, الإحسان في فعل الخير. That means while you are doing good to others, you have to do it in the best way. Not with, for example, يعني مع المن والأذى والعبوس. Because some people, they did good to others. They give صدقات to others. They help others. But every time he meets him, he said, do you remember when I gave you such a... You remember when I helped you? Do you remember when your car يعني, broke in the highway and I stopped and I did. No, al-ihsan is to do good for others, to others, and to do it in the best way. Also, some scholars define al-ihsan by saying, هو فعل ما ينفع الغير بحيث يصير الغير حسنا به. To do something good to others, but the others became good because you did this. For example, they give an example. يقولون أن تطعم الجائع إطعام الجائع حتى يشبع. I need to do good in its place. If somebody needs, if somebody is hungry, الإحسان is to do good deed to those who deserve in the right place. And some scholars, they mention something very important and interesting when they defined al-ihsan. قالوا هي المعاملة بالحسنى ممن لا يلزمه إلى من هو أهل له ممن لم يلزمه. That means it is not mandatory to do it. So you do it voluntarily. Is that not something that wajib and mandatory upon you when you did a good deed to others? It is very important because sometimes if somebody seeks your help, asks you to help, and it is not mandatory to help him, but if you did it, this is al-ihsan. This is al-ihsan. Brothers and sisters in Islam, الإحسان من أفضل منازل العبودية لأن الإحسان لب الإيمان وروحه وكماله. الإحسان is the heart of الإيمان. الإحسان is the spirit of الإيمان. And if you did إحسان in your religion, almost you complete your إيمان. كمال الإيمان. By doing الإحسان, you are doing kamal al-iman. That Allah, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Ar-Rahman, قال سبحانه هل جزاء الإحسان إلا الإحسان. The reward of al-ihsan, if you did ihsan in this life, in this dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you by ihsan. But do you know the differences between your ihsan and Allah's ihsan? Your ihsan could be $1. Your ihsan could be one good word to say it to somebody. Your ihsan could be even $10,000. But you cannot, it's not comparable with Allah's ihsan in hereafter in Jannah. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yaj'alana jami'an min ahli al-Jannah. Dear brothers, respected sisters, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrated that a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he wanted to give Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam covenant for al-Islam, bay'ah al-Islam and bay'ah al-Jihad, for jihad for the sake of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, is anyone of your parents alive? The man said, both of them, alhamdulillah, both of them are Allah. كِلَاهُمَا فَقَالَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ فَرْجِعْ إِلَى وَالِدَيْكَ فَرْجِعْ إِلَى وَالِدَيْكَ فَأَحْسِنْ صُحْبَتَهُمَا. الْحَدِيثُ مُتَّفَقٌ عَلَيْهِ. The Prophet عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ told this man, go to your parents and do ihsan to them.
and be good with them. Help them is better for you than a jihad with me. I'm telling you, brothers, if you still have your parent alive, or one of them, you are so lucky. You are very lucky. Take the advantage of this. Help them before they die. Do ihsan to them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you in hereafter, inshallah. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha narrated a very emotional hadith, a story, an incident happened with her. She said, a woman with two daughters entered my house. This woman, she asked Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha for help, especially for something to feed her daughters. They are hungry. The mom and the two daughters were hungry. Maybe this lady did not know the situation of the houses of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She entered and she asked for food. Aisha radiallahu anha tried to find something to give the hungry family, the mom and the two daughters. She found, Aisha radiallahu anha, found only one piece of date in her house. One piece of date. No bread. I'm not talking no meat, no chicken, no bread, no food. And even no date, she found only one piece of date. Now she has one piece of date, and in front of her there are three people, the mother and two daughters. She gave this piece of date to the mom, and let mom deal with the situation. The hungry mom, she took this piece of date and cut it into two pieces, two halves. And she gave each daughter one half. Then she left. This mother left. فَدَخَلَ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم فَأَخْبَرْتُهُ بِالْخَبَرِ فَأُرْجِبَ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم بِتَصَرُّفِ الْأُمْ. Aisha, she informed Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم what the mom did. And he was amazing. How she dealt. Then he said, "من ابتلي من هذه البنات بشيء فأحسن إليهن كن له سترا من النار يوم القيامة." الحديث متفق عليه. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, "He who is involved in the responsibility of bringing up daughters, and he is benevolent towards them, that means, and he is good with them and deals good with them, the daughters, the daughters would become protection for him against the hellfire." One Sahabi asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked him, كيف لي أن أعلم إذا أحسنت أو إذا أسأت? He asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how can I know when I have done well or when I have done something bad? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam gave him like yani mizan, balance to measure his action. If he did good or bad, إحسان أو إساءة. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, إذا سمعت جيرانك يقولون قد أحسنت, فقد أحسنت. وإذا سمعتهم يقولون قد أسأت, فقد أسأت. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام told him, if you hear your neighbors, your friends, of course the Prophet didn't say your friend, but the meaning of hadith. The Prophet said, if you hear your neighbors And of course, your friends, your families, people who come with you to the masjid and pray with you to the in the masjid. If you hear these people saying that you have done well, then you have done well. And if you hear them saying that you have done something bad, then you have done something bad. Because in another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, "Antum shuhada Allahi ala ard." You are witnesses, the witnesses of Allah on His land, on the earth. Brothers and sisters in Islam, أبو هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه وأرضاه قال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يوما يا أبا هريرة. I'd like to mention the Arabic first because the word of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is beautiful. قال يا أبا هريرة كن ورعا تكن أعبد الناس وكن قنعا أي قنوعا تكن أشكر الناس وأحب للناس ما تحب لنفسك تكن مؤمنا وأحسن وهنا الشاهد وأحسن جوار من جاورك تكن مسلما وأقل الضحك فإن كثرة الضحك تميت القلب. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام advised, he gave an advice to Abu Hurairah and to us also. He told him, Ya Abu Hurairah, be cautious and you will be the most devoted of people to Allah. Be content, you will be the most grateful of people to Allah. Love for people what you love for yourself. You will be a true believer and be a good neighbor to your neighbors. And do ihsan to your neighbors. You will be a true Muslim and laugh little. Don't laugh. Don't laugh a lot. For laughing a lot, make the heart die for your heart. Abu Huraira also narrated another hadith. He said, بينما رجل يمشي في طريق وجد غصن شوك على الطريق فأخره فشكر الله له فغفر له. Listen to this. The Prophet ﷺ said, while a man walking in the road, in a way, the street, and he found something harms people, branch, thorn, and he took it away from the way of people, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appreciate his action, what he did. Appreciate what he did. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive him and let him enter paradise. He did something small, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by his ihsan, he rewarded him a lot. Finally, brothers and sisters in Islam, Hudhayfah radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrated an amazing hadith. He said, تلقت الملائكة روح رجل ممن كان قبله فقالوا أعملت من الخير شيئا قال لا قالوا تذكر وكأن الميت يعقل ويتذكر قالوا تذكر قال كنت أدين الناس فآمنوا فتياني العمال عندهم أن ينظروا المعسر ويتجاوزوا عن المعسر قال الله عز وجل تجوزوا عنه. حذيفة رضي الله تعالى عنه narrated that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned an incident happened with people before Al-Islam, before أمة الإسلام. Maybe he was among Bani Israel. He died. Then the angels received his spirit, his soul. And the angels asked him, did you do any good deed in your life? He said, no, I did not do any good deed. Then they asked him, remember, take your time, keep, remember. He said, I did something. I used to do a something. What is it? He was rich and he has office, like financial, like a bank, lend people money. And the worker and the servant or the employees with him, they make sijilla, record for each one who got a loan from him. And what he used to do with these people? If somebody came to him, he said, listen, I don't have the money now. He said, no problem. He used to order, command, this employee, give him time, more time. How many days, how many months, how many years do you want? He said, give me, for example, 1 year, 6 months, for example. Give him. And if somebody came with money, but not complete, not the full amount, not the full amount. Suppose that he got a loan or he lent from him. He borrowed, for example, 1,000 dinar. He said, oh, but I have 600. No problem. Give it. I forgive you. He used to forgive people. He used to do ihsan to people. If he doesn't have, he said, delay. No problem. If he has some of the amount, he said, no problem. We'll get it. We'll have it. And we'll forgive you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave him. Because he used to forgive people. And that was the only good deed that he used to do in dunya. He did not. He said, when the angel asked him, did you do any good deed? He said, no. I do not remember. I did not. I'm not praying. I'm not fasting. I'm not doing anything good. They ask him, remember, did you do any good deed? He said, I did this and this, and he explained. Because he used to forgive people, Allah forgave him and let him enter paradise. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrated a beautiful hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man ista'adha billah fa'a'idhuh. Man sa'alakum billah. فأعطوه من استجار بالله فأجيروه ومن أتى إليكم معروفا فكافئوه فإن لم تجدوا يعني ما تكافئونه به فادعوا له وادعوا له حتى تعلموا أن قد كافئتم. Do you think there is any more beautiful than this? What Rasulullah said, Allah, you cannot. But in Al-Quran came. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in this authentic hadith, he said, whoever seeks refuge with the name of Allah, grant him refuge. Whoever asks you in the name of Allah, give him. Whoever seeks protection with the name of Allah, give him protection. Whoever does you a favor, then reciprocate. And if you cannot, then supplicate for him, and supplicate for him, and keep supplicating for him until you think, until your nafs is satisfied, until you think that you have repaid him. You paid him back. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us among those who listen to the speech and follow the best. أو كما قال ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالنجاة. الحمد لله حق حمده أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الصادق الصالح شهادة أن توجد إله بظلمة نحن، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، dear brother, respected sisters, tomorrow inshallah at 7 PM there is a fundraising for the Islamic school, and to help the Islamic school it is kind of ihsan. So I'm inviting all of you, I'm asking all of you to accept this invitation and to come, and there is a fundraising dinner. It's going to be also a delicious inshallah dinner. So do some ihsan to this school. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you and protect you and your family in this dunya, inshallah, from all evil. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all this in your skin on the day of judgment. ثم علموا عباد الله أن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ به نفسه وثنى به ملائكة قدسه، فقال عز القائل: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد، كما صليت وسلمت وبارك على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. وارض اللهم عن الصحابة أجمعين، اللهم ارض عن صحابة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وعن التابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعن معهم بمنك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم خذ المسلمين والمسلمات، المؤمنين والمؤمنات، الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك مولانا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم أبرم لهذه الأمة أمر رشد يعز فيه أهل الطاعة، ويهتدى فيه أهل المعصية، ويؤمر فيه بالمعروف وينهى فيه عن المنكر. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم لا تدع لنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا هم إلا فرجته، ولا مبتلا إلا عافيته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا ظالما إلا قسمته، ولا مظلوما إلا نصرته، ولا طالب علم إلا وفقته، ولا ضالا إلا هديته، ولا مسلما ميتا إلا رحمته، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم احفظ واحفظ أبناءنا وبناتنا ونساءنا وجميع المسلمين، وسلمنا في هذه البلاد من جميع الشرور العباد، إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم، واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
Taking the lines, oh, the new Halloween, the next term, the second bullet, and the garden for the straight bars. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأوفوا بعهد الله إذا عاهدتم ولا تنقضوا الأيمان بعد توكيدها وقد جعلتم الله عليكم كفيلا إن الله يعلم ما تفعلون ولا تكونوا كالتي نقضت غزلها من بعد قوة أنكاثا تتخذون أيمانكم دخلا بينكم أن تكون أمة هي أربى من أمة إنما يبلوكم الله به وليبينن لكم يوم القيامة ما كنتم فيه تختلفون ولو شاء الله لجعلكم أمة واحدة ولكن يضل من يشاء ويهدي من يشاء ولتسألن عما كنتم تعملون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Tonight, Dr. Sabeel Ahmed will be giving conducting a workshop, and it's about the art of interfaith discussion. The workshop will be at the UNCC starting on tonight, Friday, March 31st, at 5:30 p.m. until 9 p.m. at the CHHS 147 room. And also tomorrow, Saturday, after April 1st, from 10 a.m. all the way to 5 p.m. at Wood War 125 room. Charlotte Islamic Academy had the following announcements. Open enrollment at Charlotte Islamic Academy. Please visit our campus in Harrisburg or our website, CIAAcademy.org, to learn more about our programs and how to enroll. Charlotte Islamic Academy is hosting its annual fundraising dinner tomorrow, Saturday, April 1st, 2017, at the ISJC, Bilal Hall, inshallah, at 7 p.m. Please join us in support of an Islamic educational alternative for our children